Inspector General of Police Lemi Kajova says there is need to curb the surge in cases of gender-based violence and other criminal acts. Mr. Kajova says statistics have proven that women and girls are at risk as GBV continues to ravage communities. He says police are working tirelessly to mitigate GBV and ensure that criminals face the law regardless of their status in society. He was speaking in a speech read on his behalf by Deputy Hello? Inspector General of Police Operations Milna Muyambango, when the GRZ UN Joint Program on GBV donated laptops and printers to the police. Meanwhile, International Organization for Migration Chief of Mission Nomagugu Ngube said better information capturing leads to better evidence generation and presentation. Ms. Ngube says the UN family will support capacity building of both the operatives. All will be responsible for the day-to-day capturing and use of information, as well as the technical support staff.
The need for enhanced data collection on gender-based violence has been recognized as one of the priorities at international level by the United Nations in the quest to eradicate gender-based violence. As you may know, the demand for statistics on gender-based violence is ever increasing, as statistics play a key role in formulating policies and evidence-based programs. Hence, the gesture to enhance data collection in police stations could not have come at a better time than now. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, in 2017, during the initial phase and through the United Nations Joint Program on Gender-Based Violence, IOM donated equipment towards the operationalization of the then electronic occurrence book.
We are confident that this electronic system will improve Zambia police capacity to accurately collect and act on these crimes of GBV and human trafficking, sending out a strong deterrent message to would-be offenders, as well as reassuring survivors of our collective commitment to stamp out these vices decisively. We look forward to a day when the challenge of lost or misplaced dockets will be a thing of the past.
Copperbelt Province Minister Elisha Matambo has assured the business community in Ndola that government will not interfere.